Hey guys, thank you for joining me for another video. In today's video, we are going to discuss 7 easy tips to help you boost your IELTS listening score. First, I will go through a general overview of what to expect in the IELTS listening test. Then I will provide you with some quick methods that will help you improve your IELTS listening skills. And then I will give you 7 IELTS listening tips that will help boost your IELTS listening score. So if this is something you're interested in, then continue watching because I go in lots of detail for each point. Just a little bit about myself. My name is Miss Wafa, and I'm a certified English teacher in Canada. I've been helping coach IELTS students for the past 7 years to prepare for their IELTS exam. So I decided to start this YouTube channel to help you on your IELTS journey. Also, please check out my website at eslwords.com, where I have written lots more articles that relate to every part of the IELTS test. Here's a little overview of what to expect in the IELTS listening section. First, when you are writing the IELTS listening section, you will be hearing 4 different recordings, and you will have to answer 40 questions related to these recordings within an hour. So you will have to answer 10 questions per recording, and just keep note that the level of difficulty increases between each recording. So this is something that you should take note of. So here are some tips for bettering your listening skills. The first tip that I want to give you is that you should not waste any time when you are handed the questions. The reason why is because you don't have much time to look for potential keywords that you might listen for in the different recordings. So right when you are given the questions, I highly recommend that you start highlighting or underlining any potential keywords that may help you find the answer in the recording. And next, you need to remember synonym language. When you are listening to the recording, remember that you will most likely not hear the same keywords that you highlighted from the questions in the recording. Rather, think smart and think of synonym language and look for those type of words throughout when you are listening to the recordings. Number 3 is you don't need to understand everything. So what I mean by this is I know that a lot of students try to understand the recording, try to comprehend what is being told to them in the recording. You don't have time for that. Just try to listen for potential keywords that may lead to the exact answer you're looking for. Listen for the storyline and where it's headed. Because sometimes in the IELTS listening, the person will say, "Let's talk about so-and-so," and that's whatever they say for the so-and-so part is an indication that you will be hearing the answer next. So just keep note of that. And number 4, something to enhance your listening skills is you need to familiarize yourself with the different English accents, because you don't want to be caught off guard on test day when you have someone speaking in an Australian accent or a British accent and you're feeling stuck, like, "Oh my God, I don't understand what this recording is saying." So just familiarize yourself with those different English accents. Try to look up words that you don't understand, because I know there's some words in the British accent that's not in the Canadian English accent. So you just want to make sure you familiarize yourself with those different accents, because this will help with your listening skills. So let's look at the first IELTS listening tip that I have for you. The first tip I have for you is that you need to identify your weak point. What is your weak point exactly in the IELTS listening? Do you have a difficult time multitasking? Do you have a difficult time, familiarizing yourself with the different English accents or understanding the different accents? You need to know what your weak point is, and you need to make a plan to enhance in those certain weaknesses that you are having a difficult time with. So as I mentioned, for example, you have a hard time multitasking between listening to the audio, answering questions, reading the questions, then you need to practice this method. But it's not about me just saying practice this method. How exactly are you going to practice it? Because by practicing just multitasking, this won't help you. You need to have a plan in place, a routine in place, and slowly, gradually get better at this. For the second tip is that you need to make a plan, like I said. So once you identify your weakness, plan out how you will take action to improve it. It's one thing to tell yourself you will practice multitasking, but how will you improve? Are you going to try to multitask with just maybe reading the question and listening for the answer first, and then slowly, gradually, include a third thing once you exercise just trying to juggle two things at once first, and then you slowly, gradually try to juggle three things, such as reading the question, listening for the answer, writing the answer, because the IELTS listening section could be a bit challenging. So these are things you want to take note of. And how I recommend you do this is set a routine. Maybe tell yourself twice a week, this is something I am going to work on. I am going to work on trying to improve my multitasking abilities. And guys, slowly but surely, this is how you get better at certain things, certain weaknesses we have, is by practicing and trying to become better at it. So the third tip I have for you is that you need to start getting into the habit of looking up unfamiliar words while you are listening to a recording. So maybe you will listen to recordings or podcasts to help you prepare for IELTS listening, but don't ignore the words that you are not familiar with, because these words may come in your question, or it somehow may be a synonym word that you may come across throughout your IELTS listening test. So you want to make the effort of looking up certain words that you are not familiar with. And besides, it won't only help you for IELTS listening if you want to do this, it will also help you in IELTS the writing section, which is great because then you will build on your vocabulary bank. So the fourth tip I have for you is that you should become familiar with some different recordings, because each recording you hear on IELTS listening section is completely different. Like, for example, you will hear two people just discussing everyday life in one part, and then whereas you will hear an academic lecture of a professor talking, or maybe two group members talking about a project they have for school. So these are all different types of recordings that I highly recommend you become familiar with. YouTube, guys, YouTube is a great platform for you to get an idea of each type of recording. All you need to do is look up a discussion between two English speaking people, or an academic lecture given by an English professor. This way you get an idea of what to expect on test day and you won't be caught off guard. So the fifth tip I have for you is that you should jot down any potential answers you're not sure about. Like sometimes in IELTS listening, it could be a bit confusing. You think you just heard the answer, but it's actually it actually leads to the right answer. So if you are not sure that you just heard the answer, just jot it down, because it could potentially be the answer, or it could be leading to the answer. So it's always good to write it down, but keep listening, because like I said, that could have just been an intro to the right answer you're looking for. So guys, the sixth tip I have for you is that you should look for hints on the answer sheet. So sometimes on the answer sheet, when you are given the answer sheet, you will see there are some headings identified during each section. These heading titles are words that you should be cognizant of and pay attention to, because sometimes in IELTS listening, those headings could be indicated that your answer is coming up, because it might say things like, let's look into, and it mentions the heading name, or let's talk about, and it mentions the heading name. So guys, these are hints for you to keep note of, and these are keywords that you should highlight to listen for. And the seventh tip I have for you is that you need to pay close attention to the instructions. So for example, if the instructions to the question say to write no more than two words, make sure you follow that rule, because you will not get the right answer. Even if you wrote the right answer, but you wrote it in three words instead of two, you will be marked wrong because you didn't follow instructions. So these are very important tips to follow to help boost your IELTS listening score. Guys, if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below so you don't miss out on any other future videos. And also, please check out my website at eslwords.com, as I mentioned, because I have lots of articles that will help you in every different parts of the IELTS exam. And let me know if there's any other content you'd like to see or you'd like me to do a video on, because I'm here to help you all. I really hope you guys could score a high band in your IELTS exam and become successful in every part of life.